Hello students, welcome. So today our new topic is fish preservation. Fish mein zyada water content hone ke wajah se decomposition ka process jo hai aur bhi zyada fast ho jata hai. So that is why fish are called as they are quickly perishable commodity. So isi spoilage ko prevent karne ke liye fish ka preservation karna zaruri hai. So that is why proper methods of fish preservation it is important. And the place where the consumption of fish is taking place and the place where the catching of fish is taking place is at a great distance. So, isiliye fish hamesha fresh rahe. That is why preservation of the fish it is essential. So, that the fish it could remain fresh for the marketing, there is a need for fast transport. And also, there is a requirement of cooling facilities. Taki here the fresh preservation could be takes place. Or the fish hai, it should remain fresh. So there are a number of preservation techniques which are present in the market. And here that is how in a very less time, the easy transportation, the fast transportation, it takes place for the marketing of fish. When we talk about the flesh of fish, it has good amount of protein, fats, minerals and vitamins and also the water. So when the fish it is alive in water, at that time only it contains large amount of bacteria. So here when the fish it is living at that time, there is huge amount of bacteria present in the fish. So the bacteria it is found in body, in the gills and also into the alimentary canal, that is the gut. So isiliye as when the fish dies, here because of the bacteria present in body, gills and gut, the decomposition process it starts very soon. Jo bacteria hai, they start reproducing as the death of the fish takes place and the bacteria attack on various important organs and this is how they spoil the fish soon in a very less time. So what are the causes of spoilage of fish? There are three kinds of factors. Bacterial action, enzymatic action and chemical action. Out of these, here when we talk about the chemical action, it is the least important and it occurs in some of the fatty fishes like sardines, mackerel and cutla. As we know, there is oil present on these fish. So oil jo hai, atmosphere mein oxygen ke here contact mein aakar the oxidation of the oil takes place and due to which there is going to be the discoloration of fish. And here large number of fish jo hai isi tarike se spoil ho jati hai. And the second action is the digestive enzyme. They are also the one here because of their action soon the autolysis process it takes place. Autolysis ka matlab hai, here the digestion of cell by its own enzymes they are going to take place and this is how soon the decomposition process it starts. So bacteria it is one of the main cause of causing spoilage in the fish. As we know that there are large number of bacteria present on the body, in the gills and also the gut, that is alimentary canal. Kyunki ye aisi location hai jahan par moisture content zyada hai, like the 75% to 80% content water it is present, the moisture content it is present in these region. Isiliye bacteria is location mein zyada paaye jaate hain aur jaise hi as the fish die, here the bacteria, the reproduction is going to start and soon the decomposition process of fish it takes place. So more bacteria, they are added during the process of handling and storage in an unclean places. Aur here dusri baat ye hai ki jo fishes hain, they get damaged during the catching process also. Jiske wajah se hemorrhage hota hai and here this also increases the decomposition process of fish. So, isiliye ideal condition mein fish ko rakhna it is important. Taki kam se kam bacterial activity dekhne mile aur kam se kam destruction dekhne mile in the fish. As the fish die, the spoiling process it starts. So, during spoiling, there is enzymatic action, there are bacterial action which are going to attack on the protein and non-protein that is nitrogenous compound. Jiske wajah se here the flesh of the fish it is going to start decomposition. So jo bhi similar substances hai fish mein, they are going to convert into ammonia. Jise protein hai wo ammonia mein convert hona start ho jayega. Here there is formation of carbon dioxide, various amines and volatile fatty acids they are produced. They are enhancing the decomposition process. एंड एडवांस स्टेज ये भी है दैट ड्यूरिंग द प्यूट्रीफैक्शन, प्यूट्रीफैक्शन का मतलब है द एक्शन ऑफ बैक्टीरिया ऑन द बॉडी टिश्यूज ऑफ द फिश, दे प्रोड्यूस सर्टन कंपाउंड्स लाइक इंडोल एंड हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड विच इज गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड अ बैड ओडर, दैट इज फाउल ओडर. फ्रेश फिश जो होती है द pH is acidic, about 6.4. लेकिन as the fish, the spoil, जो भी spoiled fish है, उसका जो pH, it is going to change. It is going to become alkaline, which exceeds about pH 7.6. So, this is how the stage of spoilage, it is able to be detected by measuring the pH of the fish. So, there are some of the methods, there are some of the characters by which a common man is able to identify a fresh fish and a spoiled fish. So, सबसे पहले character है कि जो fresh fish होती है, वो हमेशा stiff होती है, hard होती है, flabby नहीं होती, soft नहीं होती. And when touched, there are no fingerprints seen on the surface of the fish. और जो eyes होंगी, fresh fish की eyes काफी glistening होगी and जो spoiled fish है, the eyes they are going to be opaque. Here the gills are bright red in color, not pink. Or just smell hogi, smell of the slime and gills, it is fish, that is fishy. And the vent region, it should not be protruding. Matlab wo bulgy nahi hona chahiye. So this is how these are the characters of the fish which are here fresh. और बाकी के जो कैरेक्टर्स होंगे, अगर ऐसे कैरेक्टर्स नहीं नजर आते थे, इसका मतलब है जो फिश है, हियर इट इज अ स्पॉइल्ड फिश. सो दिस इज हाउ अ फिश प्रिजर्वेशन वीडियो एंड्स, एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच.